from that, at that time, 3,001 time got saved and came in to the Christian community, and they began to grow together. And so I want us to look at Acts chapter 2, chapter 2, verse 42 through 47. So you can read this in your Bibles, or you can follow along on the screen. After that time, 3,000 came. It says, and they devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and the fellowship, to the breaking of bread and the prayers. And awe came upon every soul, and many wonders and signs were being done through the apostles. And all who believed were together and had all things in common. And they were selling their possessions and belongings and distributing the proceeds to all as any had need. And day by day, attending the temple together and breaking bread in their homes, they received their food with glad and generous hearts, praising God and having favor with all people. And the Lord added to their number day by day those who were being saved. It's amazing, isn't it? This beautiful picture of community in the early church. And some of you guys were like, yes, they love bread. Like, that was your thought, like, the whole time. You're like, I love bread too, man. Let's carb load after church. Like, let's just go break bread. But they're not just devoted to bread, but they are. And I love that. You know what I mean? That's part of it. But, you know, when it says breaking bread, it's talking about communion. It's talking about coming together and remembering Jesus, remembering his sacrifice, remembering that he laid his body down for us. And it says they devoted themselves. Now, we're devoted just sticks out. What are they devoting themselves to? They're devoting themselves to four things here. The apostles' teaching, which is God's word, right? They're devoted to learning, studying the word of God. They want to know the words of God. They're hungry for it. They're devoted to the word of God. You know, we come to church and we should be hungry for the word, ready, like we're eating bread. You know, it should be even a stronger urge than the desire for food. You know, we're hungry to know God's word. The second thing they're devoted to is fellowship. This earpiece is like, woo. All right, fellowship. Like, they are ready to be with one another. You know, they're devoted to fellowship with each other. The third thing is the breaking of bread. And that can be eating, but in this context, it's talking about the Lord's Supper. It's talking about communion. And the fourth thing is prayer. So we have a slide with all these. So these are the four things that they're devoting themselves to. And they're doing all these things regularly, and they're remembering Jesus. They want to just come together and talk about Jesus and encourage each other with Jesus. And then there's this thing where it says they had all things in common. Did that stick out to anybody? This is amazing. Like how powerful a picture where these people are actually taking their possessions and they're selling them so that they can meet needs of the people around them. They're actually selling things. You know, what would it be like for us? It'd be like going, man, there is a need. Somebody's hungry. I'm going to sell my TV because that's not as important as meeting the needs of somebody around me, right? This is what the early church is doing. It's radical. It's amazing. It shouldn't be radical for us, though, should it? No, it should be normal for us. This is how it all started, you know, and they're not showing partiality. You know, they're not just taking care of the needs of the people that are maybe more important or just the apostles. No, they're actually taking care of the least of these, the orphans and the widows, and they're rallying resources. They're gathering them together. And then here's this word in verse 46. It says, day by day. You know, we're in an American church culture that in a lot of ways is week to week, isn't it? It's like we show up on Sunday and then we come the next Sunday. That's not what the early church was doing. Every day, they are seeing each other, relating with each other every single day. And it's saying day by day, they're going to the temple to pray, and they're meeting in homes to fellowship and to share the word of God. And I love the book of Acts because as you read the book of Acts, I mean, weird stuff happens.